From my experience, and from the study we conducted, gastrus containing the two strains of Lactobacillus reuteri improved different aspects in the course of the H. pylori infection. First of all, it improved the clinical outcomes associated with the symptomatology and reduced the rate of side effects reported. As well, it improved the gastritis in the from the bacteriological point of view. It improved both in the gastric antrum and the corpus, the inflammatory as well as the activity scores. In addition, it improved the eradication rate when compared to the placebo treated group by 8.6%. Collectively, these benefits would favor introduction of this potentially effective treatment as an adjuvant treatment with a standard triple therapy when treating H. pylori infection. For the patients, in my opinion, I expect that improvement in the clinical outcomes as well as reduction in the side effects reported with Lactobacillus reuteri, especially the taste disorders and the diarrhea, will improve the patient compliance. As we all know, most of the failures in the treatment of H. pylori is associated with the emerging resistance and as well as the patient compliance. In my opinion, the patient compliance will greatly improve when the patient experiences improvement in the gastrointestinal symptoms as well as reduction in the frequency of the side effects. In my opinion, the future studies should focus into the resistant strains of the H. pylori and whether the probiotics including Lactobacillus reuteri or other strains would improve the eradication rates in the resistant cases, and this would certainly would favor the higher eradication rates in H. pylori infection. Eventually, as we shown in our study, a reduction in the histopathological features would certainly reduce the frequency of gastric atrophy and eventually the frequency of gastric cancer. I think the introduction of the probiotics, including the gastrus and the other strains of the in the area of treatment of H. pylori, will improve the eradication rates and reduce maybe in the future the rates of resistance because its effect is long lasting and it tackles not only the H. pylori bacilli but also the immune system and the gut innate defenses, which is an important factor in maintaining a normal composition of the bacterial flora and consequently reduction in the colonization rate by the pathogenic bacteria including the H. pylori.